हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सॉल्ट्स. सो द फर्स्ट सॉल्ट यू कैन सी हियर द प्रिपरेशन इज गिवन फॉर कॉपर सल्फेट. आर यू गेटिंग? सो कॉपर सल्फेट द फॉर्मूला इज CuSO4.5H2O एंड द मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन विच इज गिवन ओवर हियर इज बाय द एक्शन ऑफ डायल्यूट एसिड. दैट इज what type of acid we will use here is dilute H2SO4. Now children, why H2SO4 we will be using here is because in the product, that means our product is copper sulfate. In the product you can see here copper sulfate is there, yes or no? So in the product we have SO4 part. So from where do we get this SO4? We will get it from H2SO4. Okay, now let us see that how you can prepare. Okay, the first reaction you can see here is given is using copper oxide. Black copper oxide will react with dilute H2SO4, then it will give you copper sulfate, blue colored solution. Okay, then the next equation is copper hydroxide, that is CuOH whole twice plus H2SO4 will react to give you copper sulfate plus 2H2O. The third equation is copper carbonate plus H2SO4 will give you copper sulfate plus H2O plus CO2. Children, these are only the three equations from which you can prepare copper sulfate. Other than these three equations, no other compound can be treated to form the copper sulfate. Are you getting? So let us see step by step the preparation method. In the first step, what we need to do is we need to take a beaker. Now here in the diagram you can see here in the beaker you will take a dilute H2SO4 and add copper oxide or copper hydroxide or copper carbonate, any one type of compound you will add here. Then we will stir it slowly. Because copper oxide is insoluble base, so hence we will heat it. Okay, we will heat the solution. So on slight heating it will get dissolved. Okay, in the second step is filter. Now after the whole compound has dissolved, okay, we need to filter the solution through the filter paper. If there is any other particle present, so the residual matter can be removed. Now when we have added copper oxide or copper hydroxide or copper carbonate to this dilute H2SO4 solution, the product formed will be always copper sulfate. Yes or no? So hence the in the first step itself the reaction has occurred. In the second step we are only filtering the solution. If any unwanted material or any unwanted residual particle is there, so that can be removed. In the step 3 you can see we are going to evaporate the solution, copper sulfate solution now which is formed here, we will evaporate. Children, why we will evaporate here? Because on evaporation water will get removed off and the left behind will be what? It will be our product, that is copper sulfate. Okay, so here the filtrate X is in an evaporating dish to the point of crystallization. So hot saturated solution of copper sulfate is obtained. Okay, in the fourth step what we will do is cool the hot saturated solution till the time the crystals appear. Okay, so you can do the cooling in an ice bath. Ice bath means take a tray of ice and put that container containing your solution into it. So after it will crystallize, what we will do is we will remove all the crystals and dry it. Okay, so this is how copper sulfate dot 5H2O compound will be prepared. Now children, you will say that miss, here in the reaction part we are only preparing copper sulfate, Yes or no? So from where does this copper sulfate pentahydrate is formed? Children, in this diagram you can see in the equation along with copper sulfate, water is also formed. So this copper sulfate which is formed here, it is in the form of solution. That means it is already in water. So on evaporating, some of the particles will get evaporated, those which are not present. So hence we know that its formula is copper sulfate pentahydrate. So it will contain only 5 molecules of water. I hope that you have understood this part. Then one by one I will send you the videos of the next salt. Thank you.